But through all of this, the Goldfield Hotel remained a centerpiece of the town, and for good reason. Mm-hmm. As it's visually impressive, as we've stressed enough to you guys, it also marks and shows the history of the area, the once grandeur that was here.
Yeah, I mean, it's still pretty grand. It's just in a more ominous way.
State. Yeah, dilapidated in a haunted way.
Yeah. she's telling me about the pigeons or something?
The owls, I think.
Oh, yeah. Because I was like, what could they be impressed with? Look at the molding, kids. In 1908, the Goldfield Hotel opened amidst an array of fanfare, built on the former site of the Nevada Hotel, which had burned down in a fire in 1905. The hotel was first owned by J. Franklin Douglas and several other investors. The four-story building of stone and brick cost over $300,000 to build.
Yes.
In that time, that's a lot of money.
That's a ton of money in that time.
Yeah. And it included 154 rooms.
That's amazing.
Speak louder.
I just screamed. It included 154 rooms with telephones and electric lights and a heated sink. So it's a big deal.
Yeah, yeah. For like the bath, heated steam, or for like ironing out your clothes?
I think for heat.
Oh, just to make it warmer.
Yeah, like a radiator.
Because
that's steam, right?
That's what I needed last night when I was freezing. Yes. Okay, gotcha.
It's so weird, too, because it was like 62, 69 in our room.
I'm telling you, every single time we stay at a haunted hotel, I wake up in the middle of the night freezing.
Which I told you, now I'm starting to think it's your husband.
Right,
because your husband, like, radiates heat,
mm-hmm.
and you're not with him. You're with me, who's on the way. I'm cold. Like a reptile, and I'm way on the other side of the bed, too.
Yeah.
Like, trying not to be in your way, because I toss and turn.
It makes a lot of sense.
You're all alone in the bed, and you're like, I'm so cold.
When it happened this morning, I'm like, okay, clearly it's not paranormal. This happens every time I'm with Wendy.